بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. There is only one topic left from chapter 5 and one activity. So this is the layer 3 switches. Personally, I don't like actually including that topic in at this point in time because it's a pretty advanced topic and we need to learn so many concepts before you can get this notion or this concept. But we'll try to simplify it as much as possible. So as we said, if we are in the same house, we use MAC address for switching or for physically delivering the frame to that person or to that computer on the same local area network. If we don't have the MAC address, then we have to learn it through ARP. So if we don't have the MAC address, we cannot just directly deliver the frame, but we have to wait until we send an ARP request in a form of broadcast, and then we receive the response in a form of unicast and so on. Layer 3 switches, in addition to the MAC table, which is used for storing the MAC address that corresponds to one particular port, in addition to this, there is another table called the forward information base. Okay? So from the name layer three switches, it means that these type of switches, they have layer 3. So, because we said by default, switches are layer 2 device. Okay? Which means that they do not deal with any layer 3 issues. Except layer 3 switches, which it actually uses both the MAC address and the IP address for switching. Okay? So it uses both the MAC address and the IP address for switching. So the advantage of this, based on what we have studied so far, is the fact that if I don't have the MAC address of the computer that I'm trying to send this frame to, what I do is that I have to wait until I fire a broadcast ARP request and wait for the response. While doing this, what is the piece of information that I always have to know about that computer? The IP. So layer 3 switches, they can benefit from this by using the IP address for switching. So the forward information base will have the IP in addition to the MAC address to map it to a different port. Okay? So if the MAC address is available, then it's fine. We can use it for switching directly. Because we have the MAC table, and the MAC table maps the MAC address to the port. Okay? But if the MAC address is not available, then we have to wait for the PC to fire ARP and so on and so forth, or that computer has to send a frame, and based on that, we learn the MAC address of that computer and which port is connected to and so on and so forth. While doing this, we can right away use the IP address for switching in addition to the MAC address. So what you need to know here is that in addition to the MAC table that the switch uses for switching, we now have what we call the forward information base, which combines both the MAC address with the IP address and map that to a particular port. Okay? So that's in a nutshell what you need to know about layer 3 switches. So this activity here talks about a specific scenario that a switch connects now 3 computers. So we discussed the issues related to the switch. So we discussed modes of operations. We said store and forward and cut through, fragment 3 and so on. And we discussed also the auto index feature, which allows this switch to use any mode of operation on each of these ports, so that switch has 3 ports now, and each of these ports can change their mode of operation to any of the modes of operations that we talked about. And not only that, each of these ports can take either full duplex or half duplex. Okay, so that particular scenario talks about the fact that now switch 1 is a brand new switch. Brand new switch means what? It does not have any MAC table. MAC table is empty. Okay? PC1 is sending data to PC2, and S1 is using full duplex and auto index feature, which means that now it can switch from one mode of operation to another. Okay, can switch any port from one mode of operation to another. Can switch this port from full duplex to half duplex if it wants. Okay, and now we need to answer these questions and fill the blank. So I will give you like 1 minute to fill this blank based on the boxes at the bottom. Okay. So cabling used in this topology will be
straight through.
Okay. So straight through is a cable configuration. Remember, do not confuse straight through with cut through. Huh? I got this question many times. What is the difference and so on? Cut through is a mode of operation. It's a mode of operation. I can, the switch can actually change any port to work in any mode of operation at any point in time. Straight through is a cable configuration, is a physical arrangement of the wires, okay? And it's used to connect two different devices of different type, okay? Two devices of different type, which means PC to a switch, straight through. PC to a router, straight through. Switch to a switch. Eh? I forgot to bring the stick. Cut through is a mode of operation. Cut through is the mode of operation. What is the other cable configuration? Crossover. Cable configurations are either straight through or crossover. So if we have two switches, we have to use crossover cable. If we have two routers, then we have to use crossover cable. But if you connect switch to a router, straight through. PC to a router, straight through. Okay, sorry, next. To find where PC, I have to speak loud so that the recording can capture my voice. To find where PC2 is located, PC1 will send out a
broadcast.
No, why not flooding? No flooding here. PCs never flood frames. They never flood frames. Okay? PCs, they can only change the destination MAC address to all Fs to indicate broadcast. Who does flooding? The switch. The switch, even if the destination address is a unicast address, but I cannot find it in the MAC table inside the switch, then I can do flooding. And flooding means that the switch will send it to all connected ports except the one that it came from. Follow? PC2 will respond back to PC1 by sending back a unicast. That's straightforward. If PC2 receives only half of the data in the frame, it will? It will discard. When does this happen? In which mode of operation on the switch can this scenario happen? In cut through. Right? In cut through. Why? Because store and forward will always make sure that the frame is received fully and correctly before it forwards to PC2. If the mode of operation here is cut through, in that case, the PC will not make sure that this frame is received correctly and fully before it forwards, in which case PC2 may in fact receive some incomplete frames, and in that case it will be discarded. Not flood, discard. A frame in error, we have to discard. The switch receives a frame in error, it has to discard. PC receives frame in error or not complete, it has to discard. There's no point of doing any forwarding for a frame that's not correct.
Cut through. If PC2 receives many damaged frames on port 3, then S1 will likely change back to
store and forward.
Why? Because receiving many damaged frames, this indicates that the probability of error on this link or this channel has become really high. Which mode of operation conserves the bandwidth in case that the probability of error is high? Why? Why store and forward? Because it checks for errors for every single frame before it switches that frame. So in that case, I don't have to send a frame unless it's correct. So that's chapter 5. So now we'll switch to chapter 6. And chapter 6, we move up in our fancy building to the floor number 3. And we talk about the network layer. So in the network layer, we need to first talk about the basic functionality of the network layer. Before I say anything, what are the two functionalities that every layer should have? Encapsulation and decapsulation. So we know this, that layer 3 will have to perform encapsulation and decapsulation. When does it perform encapsulation and decapsulation? So when, as we said before, if we want to send a frame on the same LAN, then it's enough to use the MAC address. And then a switch or a hop or something like that, they will switch and they will deliver the frame physically to that computer. But if we want to communicate with another remote computer on another LAN, another remote local area network, is the MAC address enough? No. The MAC address in that case is not enough. MAC address is used to switch to a person physically inside the house. If we're talking about a remote house, then we have to identify the location of that remote house, and then we have to send and direct our traffic to go to that remote house. And for that, the MAC address is not enough. So we need the IP address. The IP address is layer 3. Then we have to go up. When we go up, we do a decapsulation, right? So the LAN is terminated by a router. And here we also have a router, right? So if we want to send to that remote host, what we do is that we have to learn the MAC address of that. We need to know the MAC address of that computer. We need to know the MAC address of that default gateway. So we have to deliver it physically to the postman using the MAC address of that default gateway. Then this default gateway is in fact a router, so it will decapsulate the frame and it will get to the layer 3, which is what we call a packet. The protocol data unit in the network layer is called a packet. So I do not expect anyone to say frame from now on. In the following 3 chapters, we deal with packets, not frames. Okay, this is the protocol data unit in the network layer. So now we are one floor up in the stack, we perform decapsulation, and now we are in the router. So the router now will have to perform what we call the third and very important functionality, which is very unique for the case of layer 3, which is what we call a routing. Number 3 here, because number 1 and 2 are decapsulation and encapsulation, right? So that's agreed upon. So routing. Routing is the process of directing packets
from one local network to another remote network. Okay? That's routing. واضح كده؟ So that's routing is the process of directing packets from one local network to another remote network. And in that, we need the fourth and also very important functionality, which is the addressing. What type of addressing we need, point to here? It's the IP address or the logical address or layer 3 address, not MAC address at all. Here we need the IP addressing. Addressing here is fundamentally different. Addressing here indicates the location, of the remote network. واضح كده؟ This address is what we write on the letter and we give to the postman so the postman can deliver this letter to the remote location. Okay? Because inside the house, we don't need that location. We are in the same location. واضح كده؟ So addressing here is the IP addressing or layer 3 addressing. So to get to the details of routing, so by routing here we mean that this router will have to perform what we call packet forwarding. By packet forwarding here is that we mean that this router will have to take local decision. Okay, so that it knows that based on this local decision, the packet will reach to the final destination. The best way to visualize this is imagine yourself that like you are going out of your house and you want to go to QU, right? So you drive your car and then you get to a roundabout or an intersection. Then you have to make some decision, right? You have to make some decision whether to go left, right, U-turn. So you take this local decision based on what? Based on my knowledge. I have the map inside my head, or maybe I'm using Google Maps already. And based on this local decision, I'm confident that I will reach to the final destination. That's what routers do. They perform packet forwarding. So they are connected with other routers. Okay, and maybe multiple routers, so there could be some other routers like here. And maybe a topology it looks like this. So if we have the network topology that looks like this, we have multiple paths that we can go through to reach to the final destination. Right? So same thing, you get out of your house and there are multiple directions, multiple paths, and many of them, they allow you to reach to QU, right? But some of them are better than the others, essentially, right? So that's what routers do. They have to make local decision, which is what we refer to as packet forwarding, which essentially mimics the fact that we are at an intersection or at a roundabout and we have to make decision whether to go left or right or straight. Okay? With the perception that we will reach to the final stage. So, there is a very small possibility that this local decision may be wrong. صح? If I'm new to the city and I don't have the map in my head, I may in fact take wrong decision, right? And this may cause the fact that I will go into loops and I will never reach to the final destination. Can this happen in the network? Yes. With very low probability, but it does happen. So routers, sometimes they make wrong decision. Okay? And at every packet forwarding, at every router, What do I use in order to perform packet forwarding? Same of what the switch does. The switch looks at the destination MAC address. In that case, the router will look at the layer 3 IP address of the destination. From that IP address, it knows the location of that remote network. And based on that, it performs packet forwarding. Whether to go down, up, straight, and so on.
Okay.
So that's these are the basic functionalities of a router. Another very important topic is the based on these basic functionalities, routers have certain characteristics. Characteristics here معناها صفات. يعني based on these basic functionalities, there is some implicit set of characteristics that exist in layer 3. The first one is the fact that network layer is connectionless. Connectionless means that I do not have, يعني this router does not have to establish a connection with the remote router in order to direct the packet accordingly. So what is the implication of this? Establishing a connection is similar to when you call someone, you dial his number, right? So when you dial his number, what you are essentially doing is that you are establishing a connection with that person. But in that case, we're not doing that. So routers do not have to dial each other. Okay? So there's no connection established. So what is the implication of this? The implication of this is that this router does not have to take the permission of this router before it sends anything. It's similar to sending a mail letter with the primitive mail service. I want to send to someone, so I will write his letter and I will send it with the primitive service. There is no guarantee. I don't have to take the permission of that person before I send it. Okay? Which means that it may get lost. Okay? So if I use a reliable service, then in that case I have to get some confirmation before I send it, and I get confirmation that it reached to that person. And basically, when I establish a connection, this means that all the packets or all the traffic will go in the same path because I established already the connection. But we're not doing this. We're not establishing any connection. So in that case, we don't have to take the permission before we send the packet. And that also leads to the second characteristic, which is also as important, which is best effort. By best effort here, we mean that we will do our best, but there is no guarantee. Okay? So best effort here means that we do not guarantee successful delivery of this packet to the final destination. Which means that, again, this because of the fact that we're not establishing any connection, we cannot guarantee any successful delivery, which means that the packet may actually go into loops. The router may take wrong decision and the packets may go into loops. The packets may get lost for some reason due to errors, due to anything. Okay? So we do not guarantee the successful delivery of this packet. The third and last one, which is medium independent. By medium independent here, similar to LLC, the routing layer or network layer is medium independent, which means that, and this is actually very important because remember here we're talking about end-to-end delivery. So some of these packets, some of these networks might have wireless, some of these networks might have fiber optics, some of these networks might be, copper cables or something. So it doesn't make sense that routing will have to change from one network to another. And for each type of network, we have to change the routing layer. It doesn't make sense, right? So routing is a seamless process, regardless of what type of cable you are using in this network. So that's what medium independent means. However, we will talk about one small exception to this. And it's very important to understand that this exception doesn't mean that the routing layer is medium dependent by any means. So we'll talk about this exception later on. So these are the basic functionalities and the major characteristics of the layer 3 protocols. So that will get us through the following two activities. The first one talks about the basic functionalities, which includes encapsulation, decapsulation, routing, and addressing. And the second one will talk about the characteristics of the layer 3 protocols. Okay. So which of these functionalities is concerned with directing packets to a destination host on another network?
Routing.
حد مختلف؟ So used for forwarding packets to destination.
Addressing.
Adds an IP header to the transport layer segment. This is
encapsulation.
So we'll talk about that in more details when we talk about the transport layer. Select path for the packet.
Routing.
Removes header from the frame. This is the decapsulation. And used to send back to the source in case of errors. This is address. So as we said, we are generally unreliable, which means that we don't establish connection and we do not guarantee the delivery of the packet as part of the characteristics. However, in some cases, if we have an error, sometimes we need to report back that error to the source. And in order to send anything back to the source, what do we need? We need the address of that source. Okay? Type. So in terms of characteristics, I'll give you a few seconds. Type, okay? So no contact is made with the destination host before sending a packet. This is a connectionless. Fiber optics, cabling, satellites. This is medium independent. These are all media types. So that refers to medium independent. Will send a packet even if the destination host is not expecting it. This is a
connectionless.
So connectionless means that even if the other side is not expecting us to send anything, we'll send it. We don't have to take the permission of that remote computer that we're sending anything.
But also, best effort,
best effort means that we don't guarantee the delivery.
Yeah, it's not guaranteed.
It's not received. But this is not what the statement says. Here, the statement focuses on the fact that we'll send the packet even if the final destination is not expecting us to send. When does the final destination expect us to send this packet? When we establish a connection, which means that we inform that person that we want to connect with you. Mana, we want to send you something. But if we don't do this connection, this means that if we want to send to that person, just send without taking his permission or his confirmation that we can send. Okay? Type. This is a little bit tricky. So we'll adjust the size of the packet sent depending on what type of network access. So to me, adjusting the size, it looks like medium dependent, right? Because we are adjusting the size based on the medium. But this in fact refers to medium independent because it cannot be best effort. It cannot be connectionless. So what this refers to is another very important functionality in layer 3, which is what we refer to as fragmentation. And fragmentation here means that depending on the medium type, the network layer needs to adjust the size of the packet. Why? What is the maximum size of the frame in Ethernet? Huh? 1500. Okay? The maximum size of the frame in wireless is different, in fiber optics is different, in different types of media is different. Right? So what happens if now a router receives a packet? Router receives a packet, right? And the packet size is now 1500, or let's say 1500 plus header, right? And now it needs to send it over a network with wireless. Okay? So So we'll say, okay, it's not our responsibility and we send it. But in fact, wireless, the maximum size of a frame is less than 1500. Okay? So in that case, what we do is that the router will have to perform what we call fragmentation. Fragmentation refers to the fact that this packet will have to be cut into two packets. Okay? And remember that this does not mean that layer 3 is medium dependent. All we need is just one parameter from the MAC layer that says what is the maximum size of a frame. That's it. Okay? What is the maximum size of the frame? I'm not saying what is the type. I'm saying what is the maximum size of the frame. This is a parameter that exists in the MAC layer. So the MAC layer tells me that the size is, let's say, 800. And now I have a packet with a length 1600. So what do I do? I will divide the packet into two packets. And I will send it in two different packets. It's similar to when you order something from Amazon. You make the order as one unit, right? But when Amazon delivers it to you, it may actually deliver this on different order or different packages, depending on so many things, depending on what is the supplier, how many items can the supplier handle at any point in time, whether this item is from one supplier or another or something like this. So just the fact that you are sending one packet, it doesn't mean that it will essentially be delivered as one packet. It may in fact be cut into different packets using the concept of fragmentation. And fragmentation does not mean that layer 3 is medium dependent at all. Okay? Type. It doesn't guarantee that the packet will be delivered fully without errors. This is a best effort. And packet delivery is not guaranteed. I have the right to check you. It's different wording that refers to the same thing, right? And you want to be trained on these different wording. This is the good thing about these activities is that it gets you familiar with different wording that refers to the same thing. Okay.